What is a central line? A central line is a flexible tube that is placed in a large vein and goes straight to the heart. Central lines are used for giving medicine, fluids, IV nutrition, and drawing blood. What are the types of central lines? Your child may have a tunneled catheter in their chest or a peripherally inserted central catheter, also known as a PICC line, in their arm. The central line may have a single or double lumen. A single lumen central line has one opening or tube. A double lumen line has two separate tubes within one tubing. What are the parts of a central line? There are many different parts of the central line that are important to identify. Here is an example of a double lumen central line that is sutured. The central line site should always be covered with a sterile dressing to protect the insertion site and keep it clean. The central line is stitched at the insertion site with sutures to keep the line in place and prevent accidental removal. The double lumen central line has two tubes or lumens that are differentiated by color. Here we have a red lumen and a gray lumen. On the end of each lumen is a cap. The cap is also known as the clave or needleless connector. Caps allow access to the central line catheter while preventing leaking or germ exposure. A clamp is also found on each lumen. Central lines should always be clamped off when not in use as a safety precaution. Alcohol caps are protectors that twist onto the end of the central line cap when not in use. They help to prevent infection of the central line. Why is my child's central line so important? Central lines are important for your child's medical care and quality of life. A central line can often stay in place for months to years, as long as your child requires it. However, because central lines end close to the heart, they are a high risk for infection. It is very important to keep the central line clean at all times. What is a CLABSI? Central line associated blood infections, commonly called CLABSIs, are very serious and can be life-threatening. Patients and families should follow instructions for central line care and watch for signs of infection. Central lines can become infected either at the insertion site on the skin or on the caps of the line. You will learn best practices for caring for your child's central line at home. What can I do to help prevent my child from getting a CLABSI? To prevent a CLABSI, wash and glove hands before touching the line or doing any central line care. Keep the central line away from diapers or ostomy areas when possible. Keep the central line and dressing free from moisture. No submerging in water. Wear a mask when doing cap changes or dressing changes. If the dressing or cap becomes dirty at any time, replace it immediately. Use a second set of hands when performing dressing or cap changes to reduce the chances of contaminating the line. How do I monitor my child for a CLABSI? Central line infections can be very dangerous. It is important to monitor your child closely and report any of the following symptoms: fever, sweating, fast heart rate, fast breathing, redness or drainage at the central line site, extreme tiredness, or fussiness. Although maintaining the central line requires special care, you can manage it within the comforts of your own home. Please always ask questions of your child's healthcare team to make sure you fully understand the steps and process that you will learn. You are a crucial part in keeping your child free from CLABSIs.